Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capitan Jr. Wishing you a nice day. And again, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe. And you can always click the notification bell so that you will be notified if new video tutorial is available in my channel. Okay. Now, today, what I'm going to do is discuss the air handling unit. To be specific, this is a recirculating air handling unit. Okay. Now, in response to one of my subscribers' request, he's asking me to do a control logic programming for an air handling unit. But before I can do that, let me show you simple graphics, BMS graphics for a recirculating air handling unit. Okay, now let me do this in full screen so we'll have a good day. Okay, now as you can see here, now this is my recirculating air handling unit graphics. Now, when you say recirculating air handling unit, meaning the air being delivered in the space is being recirculated back to the area being served. Okay, that's the recirculating air handling unit. Okay, now this air handling unit, the fans are not being controlled by BFD. Okay, so there is no variable frequency drive that controls the frequency or the speed of the fan. Okay, so to give you an idea what an air handling unit looks like, I have here the actual air handling unit. Okay, as you can see here, there will be fan in the lower portion of the air handling unit. Then there will be fan at the top. Okay, so I have here my supply fan. Then I have here my return fan. Okay, so this is a simple representation of this air handling unit. Okay. Now, this part of the air handling unit is the mixing chamber, or we can call it mixing part, okay? Now, so there are two fans, supply and return, okay? So what are the field devices installed in the air handling unit? Now, as you can see here, these are the dampers. So I have damper in the exhaust portion of my duct. I have damper in my fresh air intake of my duct. Then I have a supply damper here. Then I have here a, what you call this one, return air damper, okay? Now, this exhaust and this in the return, in the mixing chamber part, these are modulating type. Now, when I say modulating type, this damper can open from 0 to 100% open, okay? That is modulating type. So it can open at 10%, 20% to 100%, okay? Now this one is a open and closed damper, okay? So in this one in the return, then this one in the supply, then this one in the fresh air, okay? Now actually, it's supposed to be this fresh air damper should be also modulating, okay, because there is a mode that we call in air handling unit the free cooling mode, okay? So you have to modulate this damper, return, and the fresh air. So if you are going to implement free cooling mode, then you have to modulate the supply air damper or the fresh air damper and the return in the mixing chamber damper, okay? So when you say pre-cooling mode, you will utilize the cold ambient temperature outside to cool the room, okay? Now, in the Middle East or in some countries wherein they have extreme temperature during winter time, they have very cold ambient temperature, so you can utilize that fresh air to cool the room, okay? So your cooling bulb will just go to the minimum opening, okay? Maybe it will just open 10%. so that to keep chilled water circulation in the chilled water pipeline. Okay, now so I have dumpers. Then what other field devices installed in the air handling unit? Now we have temperature sensor. Now as you can see here, this TH is combination of temperature and humidity. Okay, so by using a temperature humidity here, you are checking the ambient condition of the air. So you will check the intake air temperature and humidity. Okay, then here also after the cooling coil, you will check the temperature that will be delivered in the area served. Okay, so you have here a temperature sensor. Then at the return duct, you have several devices. First, you have here a smoke duct detector. Now, as you know, this smoke duct detector will try to sense the air if there is a smoke coming from the area being served. Then if there's a smoke, this then air handling unit should stop. Now that logic will be included in your program. Okay, then we have here a CO2 detector. Okay, now actually I have already discussed why we are monitoring the air quality of the return air, because if the air quality becomes poor or the air is dirty, then you have to implement some procedure. How are you going to vent out this air which is having a bad quality? Okay, so in that logic, you have to open this exhaust damper to vent out this dirty air, then introduce more fresh air. Okay, now again, we have also some, we have also here a combination of temperature and humidity, okay, that will check the temperature of the return air. Okay, so what else? I have here differential pressure switch. Okay, I have differential pressure switch across the fan. I already explained what is the purpose of differential pressure switch, but to again, it will detect the airflow if the fan is working. Okay, so I have DP in both fans, supply and return. Then I have also a DP across the filter. Now this is the bug filter. Here you will be also monitoring the status of the filter by installing a differential pressure switch. Now how it will work? Let's say your bug filter is already clogged or dirty, then there will be a buildup of pressure here. Then it will be sensed by this differential pressure switch. Now, if you want to know how differential pressure switch work, you have to watch my previous video tutorial that explain how a differential air pressure switch works if it is installed across the filter. Okay. Now, what else? Now I have here a bulb actuator. So the bulb actuator is the one that controls the chilled water entering the cooling coil. Okay. So your control logic will implement a PID control that will control the bulb, okay, based on the set point and the measured variable. Okay, now here in the area serve, you can install one temperature or space temperature sensor here to sense the actual temperature in the area being served. Okay, now what are the points? We have here the different forms: fire alarm, time schedule. Now time schedule, I already explained this one, but I will repeat. Time schedule is used for energy management or energy conservation. Now you can, as a BMS engineer, you can configure a time schedule that this air handling unit will automatically start and stop. Let's say you want this air handling unit to start at 8 in the morning and stop at 5 in the afternoon. So you can specify that in the time schedule. Okay, then include it in your control logic for starting and stopping the fans. Okay, the operator enable will give the operator the ability to start and stop the air handling unit. Okay, so it will be included in your start-stop logic. Okay, so let's say your maintenance people go to the mechanical room and they want you to stop this air handling unit. Now they can call the BMS room, then the maintenance people will ask the operator to stop the air handling unit. So the operator will just disable the AHU. Okay, then now these are the, so the monitoring points for the supply fan and return fan. Hand of Alto, three fan alarm I have given you already, or I have discussed this already in my exhaust fan. How are you going to generate these software points, the alarms, and the like this airflow alarm? Okay, so this one are being generated in our control logic program. Now, what else are monitored in this air handling unit? We have the supply air temperature, set point, and supply air temperature. Okay, set point, you will specify a set point that this air handling unit will deliver the, as let's say your set point is 22 degrees centigrade. So meaning this air handling unit will try to deliver air to the area 22 degrees, okay? Now this is how it is being done through the, your PID control will try to control the cooling coil valve, okay, through the use of PID control, okay? So proportional plus integral plus derivative control. Later on, I will show you this one in my control logic program when I will do the programming of this air handling unit, okay? So what else? Okay, smoke duct detector, air quality. Okay, so the air quality, we are checking the air quality. As I said, if the air quality, that the quality of the air coming from the supply area is getting dirty, then we have to implement some routine how we are going to introduce more fresh air, okay? So supply air humidity, return air humidity, okay? Because we have here a temperature and humidity sensor, okay? Now we have here run hour set point. Again, this is for the maintenance procedure for the supply and return fan, okay? Now you can show here also the supply and return fan run hours, okay? So those are the points. Then the damper points also you will show if it is open or closed, okay? So these are a typical air handling unit BMS graphics showing some of the monitoring and control points. Now this is my actual air handling unit. Okay, I hope I have given you the idea how this air handling unit works, and I will try to give the typical sequence operation for this air handling unit so we can start our control logic program. Okay, now again, I hope I have given you an idea how an air handling unit works and how you are going to prepare your BMS graphics for this type of air handling unit. And my next video tutorial will be how are you going to do the control logic program for this. Then I will add more IO module in our automation server to accommodate the points for this air handling unit. Then I will do the control logic program. Then I will show you the how are you going to bind this monitoring and control points to our IO module and to our control logic program. Okay, so once again, thank you very much. I hope I have given you some information that will help a new graduate of engineering that wishes to join the field of building automation or BMS. And once again, Santos Capilian Jr. saying God bless us all and bye for now.